Hello guys, welcome to the WebAPIC channel. In this video, you'll learn how to add sale price to your product feed. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. Right now, in our product page, we can see that some of the items does not have any sale price and some of them do have sale prices. So let's go ahead and see how these look in a feed. Let's go to CTX feed, create a new feed. Let's keep it at United States. Let's use a custom template. Let's give it a name, sale1. Everything else looks good. Right now, under our attributes, let's go ahead and add a new attribute, which is sale price. So let's type in sale price and let's find the relevant attribute. There we go, sale price. Let's keep the price right next to sale price so it's easier for us to see in our feed. There we go. Let's update and generate this feed. Once the feed is ready, let's take a look. Okay, in our feed, as expected, we can see that some of our products does not have a sale price, whereas some of our other products do have sale prices. Now let's go back to our feed and make a few changes. We can see that one of the attributes is returning regular price and the second one is returning sale price. So let's make this change here. Let's name this regular price. And now let's add another attribute, which is going to be price. And the attribute it will be returning is price. Let me quickly rearrange these. Right now, let me go ahead and explain what all these different price attribute means. So for regular price, if you go into our product page, let's say given to one of our products, this is what the regular price is. This is the regular price of the product. Underneath that, you have a sale price provided that the item is on sale. As you can see, this item is not on sale. That's why it does not have any sale price. And the last attribute that we have is price. Now, if there is a regular price and a sale price, the price will pick up the sale price. However, if there's nothing under sale price, the regular price will show up under price. So this is how this attribute works. Let's go ahead and test it out. Right now, let's go ahead and generate this feed and take a look. As you can see in our feed, in our first product, there's only a regular price. That's why the price is only showing the regular price since there's no sale price here. Underneath here, we've got the second product, which actually does have a sale price. That's why the price is showing the sale price instead of the regular price. Let's go back to our site and make a change to this product and see how it reflects in our feed. Now in our site, let's go to our product, scroll down, and let's give this a sale price. Let's say $15. Let's update it. Now we're going to go back to our feed. For our price attributes, let's add a suffix as well. USD representing US dollars. Let's add it for all of our prices. Cool, let's update and generate this. Now let's take a look at our feed. Voila, there we go. Now in our feed, as you can see, we can see the sale price, we can see the regular price, and now the price is reflecting the sale price. Plus on top of it, the suffix we have added are also showing up beside the price. There you go guys. Now you know how to add sale price to your product feed. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webepic.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.